40 seconds left.
No, just keep pushing it. Oh my God.
In science fiction, they are often cast as the enemy. Here, a team's fate lies in their balance. A competition teaming bright young minds with cutting-edge technology. Robots are built to withstand virtually anything. Humans are not. In this arena, minor malfunctions can lead to major heartbreaks.
Oh my God, our battery's so down.
Months of work. Sat there, dead.
This is not science fiction. This is not man versus machine. This is FIRST.
Well, here we are, week one. This is the challenge this year. We have to pick up basketballs and actually put them in a hoop. I am anticipating a lot of hours in the next 6 weeks. This being week one, everybody's fresh. The veterans really don't recall how much time that we actually put into the game last year.
Let them all run and it would just feed right into the cannon and shoot them all out.
Yeah.
So it kind of takes his idea and just fine tunes it. So, and it's kind of like what you're doing with the other idea that I had where
you actually get to load them all in a bunch.
Yeah, load them all in and fine tune it. So take all these ideas that we're saving here and we'll...
We are working on a mechanism that can pull in the balls, store them, and then shoot them out. Right now we're stuck but we're trying to get all the designs and trying to see which one we like better.
Well, I'm specifically working on the design that's on the board over there, which is basically just the ball would come up over around in this area, up to these tube-like spinners, and then go inside of this chamber area, and then it would lift and then shoot out the ball. Nathan has his own idea over here, which involves somewhat similar idea, but it has a door to close for specific different shots with that's also that has to do with the balls.
We're going to be here for probably 40 hours a week after school per week. So we're going to be pretty tired at the end of this 6 weeks. We're going to be kind of cranky. We're going to be arguing with a few people. This is real life. We're going to be doing what I would say is dual shifts for 6 weeks in a row. So I wish us luck.
Yeah.
Will a gearbox be too slow?
Yeah, I don't know yet.
Okay.
We got enough. Right now with the direct drive, I don't know if we're going to stall the motor or not.
Right.
Going to stall the motor, then we need to either do something with gearbox, or sprocket.
Got it. Okay.
Look how fast those balls are shooting.
Yeah, it's also a small ball.
But still.
I agree.
I don't think you're shooting that fast.
No, you're going to slow down. You're going to be slowing down the motors. You need more gears. Follow me.
We have different size gearboxes, different types.
Are you talking about the one that's on that mock thingy right now?
See that right there? Brand new, not even used.
Okay.
We can probably take this in. Might want to hook that up to see what it can do. This is robotics, New England style. Danger, construction zone.
Yeah, I'm working with programming. Right now, I'm becoming familiar with some, they got some new stuff for how you design the code for the robot, so I'm studying that right now. I'm probably going to be working on the motors later, getting those running. Eric is running around getting the stuff to actually put the software on the robot, getting that working. We're probably going to be putting some stuff in for the camera so we can target the hoops better.
Okay, so right now, so far, we're setting up the classmate, getting it all perfectly set up. We're setting up the C-Reel so it works with the new Java image. We're flashing the dashboard that's already in there with the smart dashboard so we get a better output and we can actually set what we actually see, we'll actually see on the dashboard. Because the dashboard was made for LabVIEW. We're not using LabVIEW. So they came out with this really cool thing called the smart dashboard, and we're currently in the process of trying to figure out how that works.
We slap on the side of the robot, I'm not sure.
Yeah. We also do a lot of buttons. We make
like the sticker and the buttons.
Multiple buttons. So if you can come up with multiple, we came up with four last year, so if you can do four buttons, four different style buttons.
Well, while building this robot, there's usually a lot of stress because when you first come up with an idea for the for maybe the shooter or the indexing of the balls, when it's not working out the way you planned, that usually causes a lot of stress. So you have to find a way to get the answer, and then when it comes up with your design, like maybe it was our idea for this type of turret, and they're looking to you saying, "Why isn't your design working?" You know, you feel like you are waiting to find the reason it isn't and find the way to fix it.
Are we gonna burn someone's tread off? That's
not going up there.
No, well, he's saying that if we beat these wheels a little bit more, burn them up a little bit more, then try going up the Lexan with wheels that have been broken in a lot.
We'll go in up to the Lexan with those easily, I think.
I think we will, too. I don't think we'll have a problem going up Lexan.
I mean, feel how packed it is.
I didn't feel that. That's what I was saying, because you felt it.
That'll climb there.
Yeah.
So, besides that, it's just getting the things built in time. You know, you want to be on time because of schedule. You need to build it. You need to build it quickly. Then you have to get it wired. Then you have to get to the programming so the programming can work out the kinks. So it's all about scheduling and managing your time properly and making sure that whatever you want to build, that it is required and not necessarily as much as luxury.
Equal spaces. And then we can feed the tube.
So you're asking what diameter pipe or what?
Yeah, what do you think would be? Inch and a half, 2-inch diameter?
Yeah.
I mean, we could just try it to start out. Because ideally what I like to do is break groups up so some people start working on certain pieces of it.
Yep.
Whether it be the intake, somebody else working on the rotational shooter, another couple of us are working on the actual firing of the ball. We're going to go fire a ball in the mock-up. That way there we can kind of see what our task is.
Do send it.
So the stress of trying to figure out exactly how we're gonna play the game and then how what we're gonna create to be able to play the game effectively or attractive to other teams to pick us.
We're up here at the media center because we finished building the robot. The programming should be done, so we're going to come up here and bring the robot test driving. We're reassembling this because we had to get it through the building, so we had to deassemble it. We have it set up. We're going to, once that's done setting up, we have marked out where the key is here, and then the half circle ends here, and then we have marked out right there where the midpoint is, where the berm and the bridge will be.
Well, kids came up with some bridge knockdown device, and we're trying to prototype to see if it actually works. Jordan, if that screw sticks out too far, it's gonna be annoying. This is daytime. Kids aren't coming in until 6 tonight.
It looks to me from here 11 minutes of one. This is shop time. Luckily, we're one of the few schools that could build during the day with our shop students. Let's see. We're going to be here until probably 10 o'clock tonight. Got here at 6:30 this morning.
What's up, B?
Yeah, what's up?
Yeah, watching robotics, drinking a Coke.
I know, I'm just watching FRC competition drinking a Coke.
True. What's up?
Who's that?
Yo, to pick up the phone! Hey, how's it going?
What's up? Yo, pick up the phone!
Yo.
What's up?
So what's up, B?
Not much. Just watching the FIRST Robotics competition.
True.
I think probably one of the hardest parts isn't so much coming up with the solution as it is doing it under the time frame. 6 weeks is a very short amount of time, and it teaches you to go through the design process in a really quick and easy way, quick and on time way.
Now we have it so untested anyway, so the camera can pick up the objects on the screen, analyze the objects, give us a position in XY space of where the objects are, and then what we can do is off of that we can normalize it, meaning that we can get some number between 1 and negative 1 off of what we see in the image, and then we're going to use that to actually rotate the turret to align it with the actual, the reflective tape on the wall. And that's our plan for right now, is we're going to have the turret auto-aim to the wall, so it's always ready to fire, spin up the speed using the angle of the camera, all the operator has to do is hit fire.
Well, we're trying to design the intake mechanism for the robot this year. It's not something that I would go with, but again, like every year, I'm outvoted. And I'll guarantee you I'll come back during the competition and say, you should have listened to me. But we're trying to design a lifting mechanism. I'm going to go with the majority the way the kids want to go. We're going to see what happens. We're going to do our best. I'm going to do my best to make this thing work.
All right.
We're making very good time, it looks like. We got a very good group of kids. We got a very good group of engineers working with the kids this year. A lot of kids came back to help out, give some advice. So we're getting a lot of work done during the day. Jason's doing a ton of work on the drivetrain, which is good during the day.
I mean, these things.
Right.
They loosened up. I knew they would.
Well, they also loosened up because we took this off.
Right.
See that?
Oh,
okay.
John's got it over there. He's coming, okay. Andy. But look at how loose everything got.
Right. Wow. Well, it's going to get loose to a certain point, and then that's it.
Very well.
And a lot of kids are staying after school, trying to put extra time in, so I think we've got a great team. Next big thing right now is we'll get the shooting device on top. That is an aluminum plate on top of the machine right now. That's the bottom of our intake. So the ball will go up to that, it'll be the shooting device on top, and it'll launch the balls.
We didn't have even close to the amount of late hours or extra nights as we have in the past 10, 11, or 12 years, having done it since the beginning. This year we were able to do it within the time frame that we planned from the very beginning.
You got cut off to already. Yeah, we're not supposed to have that much tape.
Okay, sub-teams. We got quite a few sub-teams on the team this year. We have a new one. We have a Chairman's Award team. What the Chairman's Award team is putting together is what we do for the community.
All right, so right now the Chairman's group is currently working on our executive summary. We have typed them all up, and we're working on finalizing and editing them. Hopefully we'll be ready for submission by the end of the day. We're also working on our 10,000 character essay, which we're excited and a little bit nervous about, but we're hoping that's going to go well. And we're also starting up on our video portion of the Chairman's Award.
We do quite a bit for the community. We do a lot of fundraising. Last year we did, we raised, I think, $1,500 for breast cancer awareness. We do a lot of community service out there. We go out to visit middle schools, elementary schools, and actually talk to them about science and technology. What can they do when they get up to the high school? And, you know, really what we do. So we use our robotics team as a tool or a carrot to dangle in front of them to really kind of trick them into learning about the sciences, the technology, and engineering. So what I have right here is this is a different type. This is a game piece that we had a few years ago. The game was called Lunacy. This is an orbit ball. We have to actually pick these balls up, pull them into our robot, and actually spin them into a trailer that another robot was towing around, that our opponent was towing around. This was probably one of the most complex game pieces that I've seen in my 12 years. And it was extremely difficult, and the kids learned an awful lot about it. Now, what we also do is we also have a software team that's actually programming our robot this year. And they program in C++, I believe. Whenever somebody asks me about software, I say, I'm a machinist. I teach the kids how to machine. If you need to know about software, go see Eric Marcoux. He's a senior here at CTE, and he does all our software programming. He's actually teaching high school kids how to program. So this is one of the exceptional students that we have on the team this year. We also have a fabrication team, which basically is most of the kids in the machine shop and some kids from the high school. So if you're a high school student, you can actually come down and learn about machining, how to run some of the bridge ports, lathes, and saws. So it's all hands-on. And we can teach you quite a bit down here. We also have an electrical team. Tyler Patella leads that. So when the robot is complete, he'll actually be wiring up the majority of our robot with a gentleman, Bill Bitter. He's an electrical engineer from Bose that volunteers his time. Okay, we also have two other teams. We have a design team, and that's run by Scott Hull. Scotty started the program with me and 12 years ago with another gentleman named Jim Shermack from Raytheon. Jim works in our software and our electrical department working with the kids. Jim actually worked for NASA, so I worked on the Apollo project, which he has some phenomenal stories to tell us, and he keeps the kids pretty interested. And we also have this year a media team.
We haven't been to any yet. We're going to Boston. They're going to Boston with us.
Can't read my poker face. She's got to love nobody. Can't read my poker face. She's got to love nobody. Ba 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 poker.
poker face, poker face. Poker face, poker face. Poker face, poker face.
Media team did labor today.
This is our second year with our media team, and this is something that it's fairly new to us in our 12 years. We've only had it 2 years, and I'm hoping it continues in the next few years. And they're the ones who are doing this documentary right now. So those are our sub-teams this year.
Thank you.
You.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Brandon! Happy birthday to you!
Okay, we're practicing with our robot. Our robot is built. We're up in the gymnasium right now, shooting these basketballs. One problem that we did see with these basketballs is the density of the basketball. We didn't take that into consideration. When we got these basketballs 6 weeks ago, they were pretty hard. Now they're pretty squishy. So that's posing a huge problem. Instead of the ball traveling the 12 feet that we want it to travel, it's only traveling about 6 feet. Okay, WPI, Thursday, we were ready to shoot ourselves, pull our hair out. We had communication problems. What this is right here is, this is an antenna, this is the brain that goes to the robot. These things, these two things were not communicating properly. It had nothing to do with us, it had something to do with FIRST, the communication devices that they're using. They were not quick enough, so our robot kept starting, stopping, and that was the same problem for 50% of the robots.
And we have a green light on the field, folks, the first practice round of the first WPI Regional in 2012. Drivers behind the line.
Get back. Thursday. We had every problem known to man as far as communication goes. We were ready to cry. We're ready to ship it back home and call it a year.
Right now we're having difficulties with our robot. It's not responding the way we want it to. It's not communicating well with the competition.
So things today aren't going very well. Our communication started out pretty bad.
Come Friday, everything worked perfectly. We started off slow. We lost our first two matches, which pushed us to the very bottom of the ladder as far as ranking goes. Dead last. We were ranked 38th. 38 out of 38 robots. But after that second match, that second loss, we started winning. We started winning and losing every other match. But the losses, we were learning an awful lot. Some of our losses were not because of anything that we did. Our robot performed flawlessly. Then comes Saturday, we won. We kept winning. We kept winning all our matches, and we ended up coming in second place out of the whole thing. So going from 38th place Friday morning to second place Saturday afternoon, that is a huge, huge win for us. We came home with this trophy right here, second place. We have not received one of these trophies for the last 10 years.
The WPI, I think that was a... it was an interesting tournament for us because we started off with a little bit of struggle in terms of, even though when we practice here before the competitions, we seemed to be gelling very well. When we got the first practice day, we seemed to be skipping a beat. I think the frustrating part about WPI was the communication problem between the robot and the playing field caused more anxiety than the actual mechanical portion of the robot. From the tournament standpoint, that we performed very well and were able to finish second. In the overall tournament.
There we go. Almost at it. Okay. You know what? Aaron was a driver for 3 years. Came down to, he went to Atlanta with us at the Nationals. And we ended up coming in 13th down there. He's probably one of the best drivers we've ever had in our 12 years.
This is a great thing to be part of. You've heard a lot of wise things from the speakers that came just before me. And led to believe that we're in a bubble where the world is quite different than it is out there, where there is Hunger Games and reality TV and a political campaign and a lot of things that seem really strange.
Will you be taking my call?
Push the front over.
I mean, we both, yeah.
Line the balls up straight. Make sure they're in the middle.
Team number 549! Yeah!
Somebody get those balls on the bridge. Somebody knock them down. Get back off. You don't want them. Okay, do your thing. Do your thing. Get a
ball. Over there.
Get the ball.
Well, we got another 2 points.
You got it. Keep going. Forward. Okay, you got it. Go shoot. Shoot that one. Line it up. Get the thing up to speed. Get it up to speed. Rev it up to speed. Bring it down if you have to. Oh, okay. 77 seconds. 77 seconds. Get that ball right in front of you. You got it. Can you shoot short?
It just popped out again.
Damn it. Reset.
Okay, 60 seconds. Go line up. Go line up. Go over the bridge. Go over the bridge.
Wait, what?
Go over the bridge, the middle bridge. Bring the arm down. Bring it down.
There's lag right now.
Let the... Go forward. Go forward. Go forward. Come on. Go slowly. Slowly, slowly. Go over slow. Okay, let him...
You guys do it.
Come forward, come forward. Take your time. You got 30 seconds. Okay, go. Slowly. 20 seconds, you got plenty of time. Stay. Come on, right there. Come on, little on. 12 seconds, you got plenty. Go. No. You got 3 seconds. 3 seconds. Go. We won, though. Way to go, guys. We won. That's all that counts.
And there's a lot of things on the robot that can break. For example, the year before, we probably blew 2 or 3 speed controllers. Those things were $140 a pop. So when you let mechanical engineers take hacksaws and start cutting stuff over the top of electronics, we find out things don't exactly work out like they're supposed to. Lesson learned from that, so now we don't let that happen. The other thing that we had happen is the game controllers we had had this digital mode, which is cool when you're playing video games. Not so cool when you're trying to drive a robot, because it actually shuts off one of the two controllers, so you can only drive half of the robot. And we figured that out mid-competition while we were on the field. So, you learn as you go. If you think you know everything, you really don't. And you learn something new every day.
Good.
Okay,
suck one up, because we do not want to pull it. You got it. 80 something seconds.
I'll just go over the bridge.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, damn it.
Technically, you're wearing them.
We did very well. Like I said, it was going to be a tough match. We lost by one. I think we did everything we were expected to do and more.
It's 64 teams of the best of New England, so it's a lot of competition. A lot of different states are here.
It's 2:30. Basically, they're going to be taking the center of the key for autonomous, and we'll take the right side. And they said their last match they never missed a shot. So we should be getting, if we can repeat the last match, we should get all our autonomous in and be high scoring, get all our shots in, and we might get like 16 ourselves and then maybe 20
right now,
themselves.
We're going to go for all 3 quarters, and we're going to go for the 2, and that should...
No, I didn't really know what to expect. I kind of expected that, you know, to flip it on. It's what I expected in terms of the atmosphere and everything else, but I didn't kind of understand. I didn't understand the whole cooperation part. I thought it was much more of a competition, and that's why I thought defense would be a bigger thing, but I think the cooperation piece, the fact that, you know, the cooperation points for getting on the bridge and balancing with the opponent, that's just a really great idea. So I think it really makes you guys a lot more strategy than I thought. I thought it'd just be shoot the ball. So I'm impressed. It's really pretty cool. So.
I went to a VEX Robotics competition that was held at the high school, and I was impressed with that. But when I came here, it's like so much bigger, so many more teams, and it's very exciting. And like Mr. Brown was talking about, I'm really impressed with the idea of working together. I know that in the Women in Technology program, they talk about at Tyco, how everybody has to work together to solve the problem. That's basically what you do. You have a strategy and you put it into action, and when the old adage that two heads are better than one is true. Yeah, so it works well. Very impressed.
Have you been going to all the competitions?
I can't go to all of them, but I try to go to one or two per weekend.
All right, and how's it been looking so far?
I think they're looking good. I think we have a very exciting season, and you guys are doing a great job with an interesting problem.
I got one question that I've been wondering. What's the story with the shirt? One every year, or has it been one for a few years?
It's when I used to MC all the events. So when I used to MC all the events, I wore a vest, and people gave me buttons and things.
Yeah.
And my last vest weighed 23 pounds at the end of the season. I couldn't easily get it through airport security, for example. So when I stopped being MC a lot, I decided that getting people's signature would be a nicer thing than taking a pin, because this is a much more personal thing.
Yeah.
So I have a whole series of shirts, probably about 1,000 signatures per shirt.
Wow. I saw a kid walking around. He had buttons up from here all the way down.
Yeah.
So what would you say to the teams that might be watching this in the next few years?
Well, if you're not involved in FIRST yet, get involved. If you are, congratulations. Use it well. Everyone needs the FIRST experience to do a better job. You can hit the ground running in your FIRST college experience or job experience way ahead of the game if you've been through FIRST.
Me, contemplating going on to WPI to become a computer science major. And I gotta say, this is the best program I've ever been a part of.
Great.
I mean, I don't know anything else where I can stay at school until midnight working on something like that. Like something like that, and then be able to actually compete and have fun. Yeah. But it's fun.
What about you?
I'm gonna go to Brown University next year also.
Major in hand?
Computer science too.
Well, don't get too lost in computer science. Learn a bunch of other stuff too. Because computer science, my recommendation is get the fundamental ideas down and learn how to learn new stuff.
Yeah.
Because that's just going to be turning like crazy.
Yeah.
And you're going to make it or not based on the other things that you do well, I think.
Where are we? 14. Right there.
So Hartford went all right, but you were on and off. So the drive team, they're connecting a little bit better at this tournament because, you know, they already had a tournament together, so they had a little bit of experience. So, this one went pretty well. We were organized very well when we did go talk to the other teams about strategy-wise for each match. That actually helped out a lot, you know, talking about who's going to balance and who what. And in my position as the human player, but for this match, you didn't really, this game, you didn't really need a human player, so I got to sort of be like a second, not like captain or coach, but I get to watch also what's going on and take in everything too, because all I had to do was hand the ball, so I got to see everything that was going on, see the stress that was going between the driver and the operator, saying lay off, you know, don't touch this and stuff like that. It's not responding and all the stresses, but also the victory, you know, when we're shooting them, sinking those like Thomas modes, and then like getting those two pointers constantly, and then the balancing, and then when all six robots balance on like three different bridges, it's great. So that was good, but unfortunately we didn't get as far to the finals.
Hartford. We're at the Hartford Regional, and they just made alliance selections, and we didn't get picked, unfortunately. So that either means that we didn't sell ourselves enough or get our name out there, so we're going to have to probably try harder next time.
We came on extremely strong at the end. We won our last three matches of the tournament, and we were hoping to move on into the finals after that, but luck wasn't with us. We didn't have an opportunity to compete in the finals because of our record, and we really didn't performed that well Friday. But we ended up on a strong note. We won our last three matches. Everybody was excited. The robot performed as well as to be expected. But, hey, it's part of the game. We have a lot of notes that we took down for next year. We're looking forward to next year. The kids are talking about it. Okay, FIRST Robotics here at Leominster High School. I cannot say enough about kids getting involved in it. You can learn so much. We have so many people that, so many advisors and engineers that work with us. I think it has something for everybody. It's competitive. If you're an athlete, you can't you can't compete on a bigger stage. We compete in stadiums. We've been in Houston, Texas. We've competed in the Astrodome. We competed at in Atlanta, in the Georgia Dome. Where else can you compete in front of 25,000 people with a piece of machinery that you built? Okay, we compete against NASA, General Motors. We compete against robots that are built for the students. Why? Because those high schools do not have a vocational program that we do. And so what NASA does and General Motors and some of these big companies, they build them for the kids, give it to the high school and say, good luck. We have a better record against playing against teams like that. We love to play against a competition like that. Again, you win some, you lose some, but I think we have a better record. And you always want to play against better competition. You know, you can walk around and just see the technology. If you love technology, you like watching the Science Channel, the History Channel, the Discovery Channel, this is it. This is real life. You can do it here at CTE, at Leominster High School. We encourage parents to get involved, the community to get involved, the school community to get involved. We want everybody here at CTE working. This is our future. This is our country's future. So I hope to see you here the next few years. We're starting up September 1st. And we're going to be competing sometime in March. But the season for us starts September 1st. We start meeting. We start designing. We have get-togethers. That's another thing that really some people don't understand. We meet year-round. We might go on hikes together. We might meet down at Elvis's Hot Dogs on Mechanic Street together. We go out together. We hang together. This is something for everybody. And you can see just by watching this documentary, it's awesome. What can I say? I wish it was here when I was in school. Wish you luck. Thanks for watching. Good night.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Well, the party was nice, the party was bumping.
Hey, yeah.
B-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
B-I-O.
Until the fellas start the name calling.
FBIO.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the young people had a ball cause Billy Bondens get out. Get back Gruffy, bash Gruffy. Get back you flea infested mongrel. Myself, I'm man, no get angry.
Hey, yeah,
FBIO.
Two Eddie girls calling them canine. Hey,
FBIO.
But they tell me, hey, man, it's part of the party.
FBIO.
You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Say, I told. Doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Bone doggy, hold your bone. Bone doggy, hold it.
A doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Bone doggy, hold your bone. Bone doggy, hold it.
Gruffy, bash Gruffy, get back you flea infested mongrel.
Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my groove on, got my mind done gone. Do you see the race coming from my eye? Walking through the place, the Digimon is breaking them down. Me and my white talk, short, dealing, gassy color. Any caliber do, I think I knew, that's why they call me Pitbull. Cause I'm the man of the land, with it to me, they say, ooh.
Who let the dogs out? 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 Who let the
Seven, eight, eight.